Welcome to Grab and Go Info. Hugging Face provides three ways to fine-tune a pretrained text classification model: PyTorch, Tensorflow Keras, and Transformer Trainer. Compared with the other two ways, PyTorch training loops provide more customization and easier debugging of the training loops. This tutorial will use PyTorch to fine-tune a text classification model. We will talk about the following: how does transfer learning work? How to convert a Pandas dataframe into a Hugging Face dataset? How to tokenize text, load a pretrained model, and train a transfer learning model using PyTorch training loops? How to make predictions and evaluate the model performance of a fine-tuned transfer learning model for text classification? How to save the model and reload the model? If you are interested in learning how to implement transfer learning using TensorFlow or Transformer Trainer, please check out my previous tutorial, Customized Sentiment Analysis. Transfer learning using TensorFlow with Hugging Face and transfer learning for text classification using Hugging Face Transformers Trainer. The link for the tutorial will be put in the video description. Let's get started. In step 0, we will talk about how transfer learning works. Transfer learning is a machine learning technique that reuses a pretrained large deep learning model on a new task. It usually includes the following steps. 1. Select a pretrained model that is suitable for the new task. For example, if the new task includes text from different languages, a multi-language pretrained model needs to be selected. 2. Keep all the weights and biases from the pretrained model except for the output layer. This is because the output layer for the pretrained model is for the pretrained tasks, and it needs to be replaced with the new task. 3. Feed randomly initialized weights and biases into the new head of the new task. For a sentiment analysis transfer learning model on a pretrained BERT model, we will remove the head that classifies mask words and replace it with the two sentiment analysis labels, positive and negative. 4. Retrain the model for the new task with the new data, utilizing the pretrained weights and biases. Because the weights and biases store the knowledge learned from the pretrained model, the fine-tuned transfer learning model can build on that knowledge and does not need to learn from scratch. In step 1, we will install and import Python libraries. The link for the code is in the video description. Firstly, let's install transformers, datasets, and evaluate. After installing the Python packages, we will import the Python libraries. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. Torch and transformers are imported for modeling. TQDM is for tracking the modeling progress. Dataset is imported for the Hugging Face dataset format. Evaluate is imported for model performance evaluation. The second step is to download and read the dataset. The UCI Machine Learning Repository has the review data from three websites, mdb.com, amazon.com, and yelp.com. We will use the review data from amazon.com for this tutorial. Please follow these steps to download the data. 1. Go to the UCI webpage with the sentiment analysis dataset. 2. Click Data Folder. 3. Download sentiment labeled sentences.zip. 4. Unzip sentiment labeled sentences.zip. 5. Copy the file Amazon cells labeled .txt to your project folder. Those who are using Google Colab for this analysis need to mount Google Drive to read the dataset. You can ignore the code below if you are not using Google Colab. Drive.mount is used to mount to the Google Drive so the Colab notebook can access the data on the Google Drive. os.chdir is used to change the default directory on Google Drive. I set the default directory to the folder where the review dataset is saved. pwd is used to print the current working directory. Please check out Google Colab tutorial for beginners for details about using Google Colab for data science projects. The link for the tutorial will be put in the video description. Now let's read the data into a Pandas dataframe and see what the dataset looks like. The dataset has two columns. One column contains the reviews and the other column contains the sentiment label for the review. Info helps us to get information about the dataset. From the output, we can see that this dataset has 1,000 records and no missing data. The review column is the object type and the label column is the int64 type. The label value of 0 represents negative reviews and the label value of 1 represents positive reviews. The dataset has 500 positive reviews and 500 negative reviews. It is well balanced, so we can use accuracy as the metric to evaluate the model performance. In step 3, we will split the dataset and have 80% as the training dataset and 20% as the testing dataset. Using the sample method, we set frac equals 0.8, which randomly samples 80% of the data. Random state equals 42 ensures that the sampling result is reproducible. Dropping the train data from the review dataset gives us the rest 20% of the data, which is our testing dataset. After the train test split, there are 800 reviews in the training dataset and 200 reviews in the testing dataset. In step 4, the training and the testing datasets will be converted from Pandas dataframe to Hugging Face dataset format. Hugging Face dataset objects are memory mapped on the drive, so they are not limited by RAM memory, which is very helpful for processing large datasets. We use dataset.fromPandas to convert a Pandas dataframe to a Hugging Face dataset. The length of the Hugging Face dataset is the same as the number of records in the Pandas dataframe. For example, there are 800 records in the Pandas dataframe for the training dataset, and the length of the converted Hugging Face dataset for the training dataset is 802. HG train data 0 gives us the first record in the Hugging Face dataset. It is a dictionary with three keys, review, label, and index level 0. Review is the variable name for the review text. The name is inherited from the column name of the Pandas dataframe. Label is the variable name for the sentiment of the review text. The name is inherited from the column name of the Pandas dataframe too. Index level 0 is an automatically generated field from the Pandas dataframe. It stores the index of the corresponding record. In this example, we can see that the review is thanks again to Amazon for having the things I need for a good price. The sentiment for the review is positive and the index of this record is 521 in the Pandas dataframe. Checking the index 521 in the Pandas dataframe confirms the same information with Hugging Face dataset. In step 5, we will tokenize the review text using a tokenizer. A tokenizer converts text into numbers to use as the input of the NLP models. Each number represents a token, which can be a word, part of a word, punctuation, or special tokens. How the text is tokenized is determined by the Pretrained model. Auto tokenizer. From Pretrained, BERT base cased is used to download vocabulary from the Pretrained BERT base cased model, meaning that the text will be tokenized like a BERT model. We can see that the tokenizer contains information such as model name, vocabulary size, max length, padding position, truncation position, and special tokens. There are 5 special tokens for the BERT model. Other models may have different special tokens. The tokens that are not part of the BERT model training dataset are unknown tokens. The unknown token is UNK and the ID for the unknown token is 100. The separator token is SEP and the ID for the separator token is 102. The pad token is PAD and the ID for the pad token is 0. The sentence level classification token is CLS and the ID for the classification token is 101. The mask token is mask and the ID for the mask token is 103. After downloading the model vocabulary, the method tokenizer is used to tokenize the review corpus. Max length indicates the maximum number of tokens kept for each document. If the document has more tokens than the max length, it will be truncated. If the document has less tokens than the max length, it will be padded with zeros. If max length is unset or set to none, the maximum length from the Pretrained model will be used. If the Pretrained model does not have a maximum length parameter, max length will be deactivated. Truncation controls how the token truncation is implemented. Truncation equals true indicates that the truncation length is the length specified by max length. If max length is not specified, the max length of the Pretrained model is used. Padding means adding zeros to shorter reviews in the dataset. The padding argument controls how padding is conducted. Padding equals true is the same as padding equals longest. It checks the longest sequence in the batch and pads zeros to that length. There is no padding if only one text document is provided. Padding equals max length pads to max length if it is specified. Otherwise, it pads to the maximum acceptable input length for the model. Padding equals false is the same as padding equals do not pad. It is the default, indicating that no padding is applied, so it can output a batch with sequences of different lengths. After tokenization, we can see that both the training and the testing dataset have 6 features: review, label, index level 0, input IDs, token type IDs, and attention mask. The number of rows is stored with the name numRows. Next, some data processing is needed to make the training and testing datasets compatible with the model. Review and index level 0 are removed because they will not be used in the model. Label is renamed to labels because the model expects the name labels. The format of the datasets is set to PyTorch tensors. After the data processing, we can see that both training and testing datasets have 4 features. Dataset train 0 gives us the content for the first record in the training dataset in a dictionary format. Labels is the label of the classification. The first record is a positive review, so the label is 1. Input IDs are the IDs for the tokens. There are 32 token IDs because the max length is 32 for the tokenization. Token type IDs is also called segment IDs. BERT was trained on 2 tasks, masked language modeling and next sentence prediction. Token type IDs is for the next sentence prediction, where 2 sentences are used to predict whether the second sentence is the next sentence for the first one. The first sentence has all the tokens represented by zeros, and the second sentence has all the tokens represented by ones. Because our classification task does not have a second sentence, all the values for token type IDs are zeros. Attention mask indicates which token ID should get attention from the model, so the padding tokens are all zeros and other tokens are ones. In step 6, we will put the training and testing datasets into DataLoader. DataLoader is a parallel data loading process by PyTorch. It increases the data loading speed and decreases memory usage. Dataset takes the dataset name to put in the data loader. Shuffle equals true indicates that the data will be reshuffled at every epoch. The default value is false. We set it true for the training dataset and keep the default false for the testing dataset. Batch size equals 4 means that 4 samples will be loaded for each batch. The default value is 1. Before putting the dataset into DataLoader, the unoccupied cached memory is released by torch.q.emptycache. In step 7, we will load the pretrained model for sentiment analysis. Auto model for sequence classification loads the BERT model without the sequence classification head. The method from pretrained loads the weights from the pretrained model into the new model, so the weights in the new model are not randomly initialized. Note that the new weights for the new sequence classification head are going to be randomly initialized. BERT base case is the name of the pretrained model. We can change it to a different model based on the nature of the project. Num labels indicates the number of classes. Our dataset has two classes, positive and negative, so num labels equals 2. In step 8, we will set up the learning rate scheduler using the getScheduler method. Name equals linear indicates that the name of the scheduler is linear. Optimizer takes Atom W as the optimizer. Atom W is a variation of the Atom optimizer. It modifies the weight decay in Atom by decoupling weight decay from the gradient update. Params takes the model parameters. LR is the learning rate. Num warmup steps equals 0 indicates that there are no warmup steps. Num training steps is the number of training steps. It is calculated as the number of epochs times the number of batches. We set the number of epochs to be 2, meaning that the model will go through the whole training dataset 2 times. The number of batches is the length of the training data loader. Then we set the model to use GPU if it is available. In step 9, we will run the PyTorch training loop for the transfer learning model. Model.train tells the model that we are training the model. Some layers work differently for training and evaluation, and model.train helps to inform the layers that the model training is in progress. Then the PyTorch training loop runs through each batch for each epoch. Firstly, the data is fetched from the batch and passed into the model. Then, the output of the model is used to calculate the loss and update the weights based on backpropagation results. After that, the learning rate scheduler is executed and the gradients are cleared. Finally, the progress bar is updated to reflect the training progress. In step 10, we will talk about how to make model predictions and evaluations using PyTorch. Hugging Face has an evaluate library with over 100 evaluation modules. We can see the list of all the modules using evaluate.list evaluation modules. We will use 3 metrics to evaluate the model performance. They are accuracy, F1, and recall. Accuracy is the percentage of correct predictions. It ranges from 0 to 1, where 1 means perfect prediction. The higher value the accuracy is, the better the model is when the data is balanced. Recall is also called sensitivity or true positive rate. It is the percentage of positive events captured out of all the positive events. The value for recall ranges from 0 to 1. The higher value the recall is, the better the model is. F1 is a metric that balances precision and recall values, and it should be used when there is no clear preference between precision and recall. The F1 score ranges from 0 to 1, with the best value being 1 and the worst value being 0. The prediction and evaluation process starts with model.eval, which tells PyTorch that we are evaluating the model instead of training the model. Because the model evaluation is processed in batches, empty lists are created to hold all the prediction results for logits, predicted probabilities, and predicted labels. The model predictions and evaluations are completed in the same loop for the batches. Note that since this is the prediction step, no epoch is needed. Firstly, we get the data from the batch and pass it to the model for prediction. Torch.nograd is included to disable the gradient calculation. The gradient calculation is disabled for the prediction because it is only needed for the training process. Then logits are extracted from the prediction output and appended to the list logits all. Logit values from all classes do not sum up to 1. To get the predicted probabilities, torch. Softmax is applied on the logits. Dim equals 1 means that the softmax is calculated based on the rows, so for each sample, the predicted probabilities for all classes sum up to 1. The label prediction can be based on either logits or predicted probabilities. In this example, we are using logits, but the predicted probabilities should give the same results. Dim equals minus 1 means that the last column is the event of interest. After having the predictions, the model performance metrics are calculated. References takes the true labels for the batch. The evaluation results show that the model has 0.945 accuracy, 0.943 F1 score, and 0.929 recall value. Logits all colon 5 gives us the first 5 batches of logits. We can see that the prediction has 2 columns. The first column is the predicted logit for label 0 and the second column is the predicted logit for label 1. Each batch has 4 samples. Predicted prob all colon 5 gives the first 5 batches of the predicted probabilities. We can see that the sum of each row adds up to 1. Predictions all colon 5 gives the first 5 batches of the predicted labels. We can see that the 1s correspond to the higher value of logits and the 0s correspond to the lower value of the logits for each sample. In step 11, we will talk about how to save the model and reload it for prediction. Tokenizer.save pretrained saves the tokenizer information to the drive and model.save model saves the model to the drive. We can load the saved tokenizer later using autotokenizer.fromPretrained and load the saved model using auto model for sequence classification.fromPretrained. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about natural language processing, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.